But at the end of the day, the beliefs that they have are indistinguishable from the Klan and from any kind of white supremacist.
Who is Jared Taylor?
Jared Taylor is the most important white nationalist operating right now. He runs a group called American Renaissance, holds annual conferences that bring extremists from all over the place to Tennessee, for the most part, to talk about why white people are superior to black people and brown people. That's his whole thing.
Hello,
Mr. Taylor, how are you?
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Thanks so much for
allowing
us to come in. Thank you.
My pleasure. All around the world, wherever you look, if you see conflict, people diligently slitting each other's throats, whether it's in the Middle East, whether it's in Africa, it's because of diversity. Diversity of ethnicity, of language, of religion, but primarily of race.
So you want to live in a white-only country?
Not necessarily white-only, but a country that is clearly based on a European model in which whites will basically remain the overwhelming majority in perpetuity.
Okay, how do you achieve that?
Well, that's an excellent question. Donald Trump has got some first good steps in mind. Mm-hmm. He wants to make sure no more illegal immigrants come into the country, and he wants to make sure that all illegal immigrants here go back. He wants to end birthright citizenship. He wants to put at least a temporary ban on Muslim immigration.
What happens with Asians? What happens with African Americans? What happens with Latinos?
What happens to my
people? You presented me with a very limited view of the United States.
You're saying the United States is a place anybody can come and turn it into anything you want, and the people who built this country and established its institutions, if they glimmer away, so what? You are promoting a process that would reduce my people to a minority. You want more power for Latinos. That comes at the expense of my people's power.
We're 17% of the population,
right,
and we only have 3 senators. So therefore, we don't have the political representation that we deserve.
And you want more and more and more?
Of course, because we only have 3 senators.
How much political?
At this point, 14 senators.
And 50 years from now, how many would you like?
Let's talk about 50 years from now. In 2044,
yes,
white non-Hispanics will become a minority. Yeah. Is that what you're afraid of?
Mr. Ramos, it's fantastic for you for my people to lose power and become a minority. That's fantastic for you. How does it feel for
because
me?
Because it is our country, Mr.
Our
Taylor.
Country, our
it
country.
It is our country. Don't you think we both have the same rights in this country?
I think that despite this nonsense in the declaration about anybody being anyone,
excuse
the white
me,
people,
you don't
the
think
white people,
we are all created equal?
No. What you want to do is change this country into an entire nation in which white people will become refugees in their own land if your vision comes through.
You don't want to live alongside Mexicans.
Now, why is it wrong for me not to want my neighborhood to change?
If
my neighborhood is European, if my neighborhood, they don't keep chickens in the backyard that crow at 3 in the morning.
What are you
they
talking about?
That's
a complete stereotype. That's a complete stereotype.
Yes, and stereotypes are all true, aren't
they? That's a racist stereotype, what you're saying.
Oh, racist. Give me a break.
What are you going to do with the thousands of Muslims?
We certainly
American don't. Citizens. Who are serving in the military.
I'm sure that we just couldn't possibly survive with all those Muslim Navy Rangers. Yes, I'm sure that's true.
That is not right.
No. I'm talking
about you cannot make fun of people who are saving our lives.
They want special holidays and special food in
school. So if you don't like their religion, you don't have to join them. That's fine.
Well, no,
but you can't discriminate against them. Simply because you...
Of course, anyone should have the right to discriminate against anyone he wishes. And the point is...
But not by the law, Mr. Taylor. You can't do that.
I think the law is absolutely incorrect.
Do you feel that whites are superior, are more intelligent than blacks?
I think on average, whites are more intelligent than blacks, and North Asians are more intelligent than whites.
How can you say that?
How can you think otherwise?
Mr. Taylor,
what evidence would you have to think that a pygmy is, on average, is just as intelligent as a Dane? Why would you think that? The entire record of history is completely consistent with the assumption that black Africans are less intelligent on average than Asians or Caucasians.
That's absurd. That's repugnant and absurd.
Repugnant to you?
Yes, of course.
Why would you even entertain the possibility that on average a pygmy is as intelligent as a Japanese?
The comparison that you are trying to make, it is simply impossible because of historical circumstances, because economic conditions, because of the movement.
More excuses. We have to be willing to say to all those who are non-European, we wish you well, but this territory is for us. And sorry, we have the right to be us, and only we can be us.
So you want me to leave?
Under certain circumstances, yes, we would ask you to go. Unless whites are prepared to exclude people, then they will be shoved aside. That is the fate which I will fight until my last breath.
Trump, I have a question about immigration.
Okay, who's next? Yeah, please.
Your immigration plan is
excuse
full
me,
of
sit down. You weren't called. Sit down.
Mr. Trump, no, I'm a
sit
reporter
down.
As an immigrant and as a U.S. citizen. I have the right to ask the question.
No, you
and
don't.
This is the question.
You haven't been called.
No, I have the right to ask the question.
Go back to Univision.
This is the question.
Go ahead.
You cannot deport 11 million.
Go ahead.
You cannot deport 11 million people. You cannot build a 1,900-mile wall. You cannot deny citizenship to children in this
sit
country.
Down,
and with those
you're
ideas,
you
I'm, a, no, 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 I'm a reporter and I have, I'm,
here,
don't touch me, sir.
Please,
don't touch me,
here.
Sir.
Please
you cannot
disrupt.
Touch me. I have the right to ask a question.
Yes, in order, in
I have,
terms,
I have
sir,
the right sir. To ask a question.
Can you give me your credential?
I have the right
where?
To ask a
where?
Question.
Where? Let me see it.
It's over there.
So they're coming out, stay out.
You just gotta wait your turn.
You're very rude. It's not about you.
It's not about
get out of my country. Get out.
This is
not
my,
about
I'm a,
you.
I'm a U.S. citizen too.
Well, whatever. No, Univision. No, it's not about you. You're
it's not about you. It's about the United States.
No, it is. It's about the United States.
Hate is contagious. That expression of hate is something that I had never experienced before. It's something that I reported about, but never experienced it myself.